Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today I'm gonna take a look at this pretty neat little brushed speedboat called the Vector XS. Now the model number on this, let me show you guys the box. It shows it on the box here. It is the Racens who makes this, the Vector XS, I guess for extra small. It says 30 plus kilometers per hour. The model number here is a 795-4. And as you guys can see, it does have that auto rollback or self-righting feature. So if you capsize this boat, reverse it forward, and it'll roll itself back and pop back up. So it'll do this and come back over. So you don't have to worry about getting a real boat to go out and grab this guy. Now, I'm out here by this little lake where I've done some reviews. So I'm going to take it out today and we'll drive it around. I'm not going to do a full table review because this boat just does not have much that comes with it. You got your charger and your battery. The battery is a two cell lithium ion. It's, of course, so it's 7.4 volts, 360 milliamp hour. It's a 15C. And then it gives you a USB charger. It does use a little funky 4-pin connector. So you guys would have to use one of these unless you swap the plugs for this little guy. And then let me grab, there's some accessories here. You got a little prop wrench like and an extra prop. And then they do give you, if I can find it here, they give you a little stand that the boat can go on so you can store it in your house without setting anything on the little rudder. Now I did do a little test run of this guy at my house inside my pool, and it went along pretty good. Now my pool's not that big, so you know I wasn't able to really open it up too long, but it didn't seem to have the widest turning radius. We'll see how it works here today. It does have water cooling, so let me open this up here and pop this open, and you guys can see your little brushed motor. This red JST plug is running from the receiver ESC combo to it. So I guess you could unplug this and if you needed to replace the motor, I guess. But that actually, like I said, your battery plug is here. Here's your little steering servo, and here's a little hose in here. I think the water comes, there's a port there, and then there's a port on the bottom, I believe, is where the hose comes up. And it will pull the water through and expel it, and that helps cool just the motor is what it runs across. It doesn't have anything on top of the ESC. So I don't know how long this guy runs. It should go into a low voltage state and slow down so you can recover it. I don't know if we'll drive it that long or not. Not sure on the range, but again, this is meant to keep relatively close to you. This should be a nice little beginner boat for someone who just wants to get into an RC boat, or maybe for a younger person who's just starting out in the hobby. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna stop the video here, get the battery, there's some Velcro to hold it in place, get the battery all in here, and make sure you lock this down so it's sealed, so if it does capsize, water won't get in there and ruin anything. And I'll be right back and we'll get it out here on the water. So be right back, guys. Got the boat all bound up. Now I didn't go over the controller. You see it's got some steering and throttle reversing. It's kind of meant to be used on a lot of different models, things you wouldn't necessarily need. Your power light, you've got some, you know, your trim, stuff like that, your pretty basic stuff. Here's your steering trim right here. So as you guys can see, it doesn't have any safety feature out of the water. So be sure you don't bump it and you could hit your fingers. It could hurt. It's not gonna cut you up or anything. But some of the bigger boats, especially the brushless, will have little, you know, metal connectors to where it's in the water, it makes a connection. And then that, of course, protects you from being able to accidentally start it up outside of the water. But this boat doesn't have that, so we'll drive it around right here and, you know, see how it works. I really want to see that turning radius, because that was my only thing I noticed in the pool, was it just seemed like I didn't have much steering, really tight steering. We'll see, it may do really good here now that I can open it up. And oftentimes these boats might turn one direction better than another direction. So let's go ahead and toss it in the water here and we'll send it out. That's pretty cool, isn't it? And that's pretty darn fast. That's, so you can go in reverse. It's not gonna do much. Let's turn right. So right's turning pretty good. Let's take it out a little far. Let's turn it left. Yeah, left does not steer nearly as tight. Look how big that turn is on left. But right steers really tight. And it doesn't seem like it really needs trimmed up. So it's not like it's trimmed one direction doing it. It just doesn't turn really tight to the left. But like I said, these toys tend to do that. They sometimes will steer really well one direction and not so much the other. So let's see, I got him over here by the shore. There we go. Yeah, that moves, man. So yeah, if you're gonna do some tight turns, look at that, boy. It just really turns sharp when you turn to the right. Look at that. This is awesome. Just when you're gonna turn left, make sure you got, look at that, tons of space you're gonna need to turn. So just turn it right like that, and look, I can turn right around, and you're fine. Yeah, so this boat now, it's possible you could get this boat and it might turn better, you know, left and not right. But again, this is not uncommon for these to do that. Yeah, this is a fun little boat. I usually will time these, and not always, but what I like to do is just bring it in early, because you don't always know how well that low voltage is going to work before it might just not give enough juice to make it back to the shore. But I tell you what, this Osmo Action I'm wearing now is great, but the camera's heavy. If you see it move, you probably won't notice it with the image stabilization, but I have to keep pushing it up on my head because it's pushing down on my sunglasses. I got to get used to this. It's a much, much heavier camera than my 8S. Yeah, this is great. Yeah, going all the way. Ugh. Just turn it right, because yeah, it really is a huge steering radius to the left. Kind of disappointing how large that is, but again, I don't think it's a big deal. This is not a real expensive boat. All right, guys, I'm gonna bring it back in now. We probably got several minutes left, but just to be safe. See if I can grab it here and we'll end this video. All right, guys, that wraps up the review of the little Racing Vector XS. I think it was a 795-4. Really cool. Just doesn't turn really well one, I think it was, what was it, left? But yeah, otherwise it's awesome. Inexpensive. If you're interested in this boat, you can pick it up at Banggood. I'll include a purchase link to this down in the description. It's not very expensive, and I don't think it was very, in fact, the shipping was probably free as small as this is. All right, guys, that wraps up the review. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any questions, be sure to ask in the comments. Be sure to subscribe. Click that bell so you know when I do upload a new video. And as always, guys, have a wonderful day. The power of the dark side.